announcements today. Tonight is the Christmas Eve service at 7. Next week on the 31st, there'll be a congregational meeting immediately following the service. Are there any other announcements that we may have missed? Seeing none, let's praise the Lord this Christmas Eve.
Because that's what we came here to do. Our call to worship this morning from Isaiah 52. How beautiful on the mountains are the feet of those who bring good news, who proclaim peace, who bring good tidings, who proclaim salvation, who say to Zion, your God reigns. Listen, your watchmen lift up their voices together, they shout for joy. When the Lord returns to Zion, they will see it with their own eyes. Burst into songs of joy, and together, your ruins of Jerusalem. For the Lord has comforted his people. He has redeemed Jerusalem. The Lord will lay bare his holy arm in the sight of all the nations, and all the ends of the earth will see the salvation of our God. Amen. Please look to our sentences from Psalm 96. For all the gods of the peoples are idols, but the Lord made the heavens. Honor and majesty are before him. Strength and beauty are in his sanctuary.
Ascribe to the Lord, O families of the peoples. Ascribe to the Lord, glory to his strength.
Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name. Bring an offering and come into his courts.
Worship the Lord in holy splendor. Tremble before him, all the earth.
Say among the nations, the Lord is king. The world is firmly established. It shall never be moved. He will judge the peoples with equity.
Let the heavens be glad, and let the earth rejoice. Let the sea roar, and all that fills it.
Let the fields exult and everything in it. Then shall all the trees of the forest sing for joy.
Before the Lord, for he is coming, for he is coming to judge the earth. He will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with his truth.
Amen. From Titus chapter 2. For the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation to all, training us to renounce impiety and worldly passions, and in the present age to live lives that are self-controlled, upright, and godly, while we wait for the blessed hope and the manifestation of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. He it is who gave himself for us, that he might redeem us from all iniquity and purify for himself a people of his own, who are zealous for good deeds. Grace, mercy, and peace be with you from God the Father and our Lord Jesus Christ. You'll note this is usually when we would go into the first hymn, but all of the hymns have been moved into the cantata, so now we come to the responsive reading from John 1. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. Received him, who believed in his name, he gave the power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of flesh, or of the will of man, but of God.
And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory of the Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
To the Lord.
prayer in unison at the bottom of page 2. Let's pray together. O Holy One, heavenly angels spoke to earthly shepherds, and eternity entered time in the child of Bethlehem. Through the telling of the Christmas story, let our temporal lives be caught up in the eternal, in that same child, that we might join shepherds and all the heavenly hosts in praising the coming of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Amen. This brings us to the sharing of our joys and our concerns. Our weekly prayer list. We are praying for Jim Lee, for Jenny Shippey, for Pam Howard, for Mike and Kathy Whitehead, for Doug Gould and Johnny Cranfield, for Miss Millie, for Joe and Donna Flynn, for Tristan, for the Sauter family, for Georgia Beattie, for Zoe Lansing, for all those with unspoken prayer requests, for world unrest and those who are caught in dangerous places, for our military and our first responders, also Reverend Bill DeYoung and his wife Diane are requesting prayers for some of Bill's relatives who are severely ill. Sister Carolyn's kidneys are failing. Brother Ron is in the hospital. Niece Lois Ruth is on life support, suffering from congestive heart failure and sepsis with not much hope of recovery. Niece Cindy's husband Jerry has post-surgical blood clotting extending from his armpit to his wrist. And Bill and Diane are recovering from a bad bout of COVID. They didn't ask for prayers for themselves, but they've been included here. So, a lot of folks in need of prayer right now. Is there anyone else? Sue?
There's a young woman named Chelsea who has been in a Cleveland hospital since October awaiting a heart transplant. Yesterday, the doctor successfully performed one. So prayers for her, but also prayers for the family that lost a woman.
Yes. Heart transplants are bittersweet. Sue?
My mother's cat fell on Friday and fractured her back. She's in Albany bed, and I just like prayers for comfort for her, pain relief, and let her know that she's loved and be surrounded by a wonderful family.
Absolutely. Pray for that. Deb?
Last week we prayed for my brother Raymond. The valve replacement was a success. He is now, after healing from that, will be going and having a surgery because they found a blockage there. And also a few weeks ago we prayed for my grandson's aunt, Tammy. The diagnosis is cancer. She has lung cancer that metastasized into her back and into her brain. She has begun radiation therapy. They're trying to figure out exactly what kind of chemo is going to take place. Tammy has an 11-year-old and a very soon to be 3-year-old. So prayers for her and the family, prayers for the boys. And anyone that's dealing with this disease, prayers for them also.
Absolutely. That's a hard one. Karen?
I'm going to turn this a little bit to Joyce. Number one, joyful for the choir. Everybody, look at how many people we have sitting in our choir loft, so yay for the choir. And the other thing, Daisy Lansing, my youngest, also Pete's youngest. Forget that. We
PT is working for it?
Yes.
Good. Well, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you as always that we come into your house, we gather in your name, we're here to worship you, and that you meet with us here, that you hear our prayers, and that you want us to bring you our prayers. Lord, not only when we're here, but always, you want us to come to you. Father, we pray for all of those right now who are battling cancer. Lord, we pray for Jen, for Jenny, for Pam. Lord, we pray for Tammy. Father, we pray that you would touch them, that you would minister to them, that you would bring healing and life and hope. And we pray, Lord, that you would do what only you can do. Father, that you would guide the doctors, but where the doctors leave off, that you would take over. Lord, we pray for all of those who are not able to be with their families today, that you would watch over them, that you would be with them, and that they would know that they're in your hands and that they're on our hearts. Father, we pray for John, that you would continue the healing work that you're doing in him, for Paul, that the treatment of this infection would be effective. Father, we pray for Pat, that you would be with her, that you would minister to her, Lord, that you bring healing and relief to her, but also that she would know that she is loved. Lord, we thank you that Raymond's surgery went well. We pray now that you would be with him as this stent is put in. Father, we thank you. We thank you for Daisy's engagement. We pray that your hand of blessing would be on them. We thank you, Lord, that Chelsea was able to have this heart transplant. We pray that there would be no complications, no problems, no rejection issues, that everything would go well. Lord, for the family that has just lost a loved one, we pray that you would comfort them with the comfort that only you can give. And Lord, that they would find peace in knowing that a life has been saved. Lord, we pray for Mike and Kathy and for Joe and Donna, that you would touch them, that you would minister peace to them, healing. Father, that you would surround them and keep them safe. Lord, for all of those dealing with long-term issues, back pain, whatever, that you would touch them, that you would minister to them, that you would strengthen them. Father, we pray for Reverend DeYoung and his family, that you would minister to them. Lord, we ask that you would bring healing in them. Lord, for Carolyn and for Ron, for Lois, for Jerry, we pray, Lord, that you would touch each one of them. Lord, there are limits to what medicine can do, but there is no limit to what you can do. You are the God of hope. You are the God of peace. You are the God of joy, and you are the God of love. And because you love us, you give us hope and peace and joy, even when our circumstances say we shouldn't have them. I pray, Lord, that you would bring those to be right now in each of these situations. Father, as we celebrate the coming of the Prince of Peace, we pray for those who are living in places that are torn by war. We pray that you would protect the innocent, and we pray that you would bring about just and lasting peace. Lord, for all of those needs that are on hearts that haven't been brought forward, that can't be spoken out, but you know them, we pray, Lord, that you would be there for each of them. Lord, we pray for all of those who serve, whether it's in the military or on the mission field or here at home, that you would watch over them, keep them safe, strengthen them for the work that they do. Help them to do it wisely and well. Bring them home safely. Father, for all of those who right now are battling COVID or any other illness, may not be life-threatening, it may just be an inconvenience, but it's at a terrible time. We pray, Lord, that you would touch them. Father, we pray for those who are traveling that you would watch over them, bring them safely to their destination. And Lord, we thank you that in the midst of everything that's happened, we can still give you praise and honor and glory because of the good things that you've done for us. Not least of all, the fact that you have given us salvation. All of this we pray in Jesus' name. Let's pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Amen. Well, that brings us to the offering of our lives. Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated.
Kids, is that having you all climb down?
Well, if you want to, you can. I was going to say, I can talk to you from where you're at today, but if you want to come down, come on down. So I already named them all off. We started out with hope, and then we lit the candle of peace, and then we lit the candle of joy, and you know what today is?
Love.
Love, yes. What is love? Someone you care about. That's a good answer. Okay. How do you know you're getting love? If they care about you, how do they show it? They smile at you. That's good. How about the amount of time they spend? If somebody loves you, do they spend a lot of time around you? Do they like to spend time with you? Well, if God loves us, how much time does He spend with us? All the time, because He's in our hearts. The whole reason that Jesus came was because He loved us. And because He came, now He's able to spend all the time with us. He's able to be in our hearts every minute of every day. And if we listen to Him, He's able to help us know what the right thing is to do, and maybe what the wrong thing is to do. And if we didn't listen in time and we did the wrong thing, He's able to help us to know that maybe we need to go back and tell somebody, I'm sorry. And that's love too, isn't it? So, we love Him and each other because He first loved us. Right? All right. Let's go light some candles. Now we need you. Heavenly Father, we pray now that everything that's said, everything that's done would bring honor and glory to You in Jesus' name. To us a child is born, and to us a son is given, and the government shall be upon His shoulder, and His name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of His government and peace there will be no end, and on the throne of David and over His kingdom He will establish it and uphold it with justice and righteousness from this time forth and forevermore. Isaiah 9, 6, and 7. Those words were spoken about 700 years before the events that we're going to talk about today. God created the heavens and the earth. He organized the paths of the planets, the stations of the stars, and the order of the animals. But no sooner did He put mankind in charge when we destroyed the whole plan that He had. We introduced sin and chaos and death to the world. Now beauty and serenity still exist, but now we have to look for them. And God was telling people from the start that his plan was to save mankind from the sins that they had committed. And now, the time has come. A priest named Zechariah is burning incense in the temple when an angel brings him a message from the God whom he is worshiping.
Don't be afraid, Zechariah. God has heard your prayer. Your wife Elizabeth will have a son, and you will name him John. He will be your pride and joy, and many people will be glad that he was born. As far as the Lord is concerned, he will be a great man. He will never drink wine or other liquor. He will be filled with the Holy Spirit even before he is born. He will bring many people in Israel back to the Lord their God. He will go ahead of the Lord with the spirit and power that Elijah had. He will change parents' attitudes toward their children. He will change disobedient people so that they will accept the wisdom of those who have God's approval. In this way, he will prepare the people for the Lord.
Amen. I ask the congregation to please stand and join us in hymn number 127, Thou Didst Leave Thy Throne. Message for a virgin in Nazareth, a girl named Mary.
You are honored very much. You are a favored woman. The Lord is with you. You are chosen from among many women. Mary, do not be afraid. You have found favor with God. See, you are to become a mother and have a son. You are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great. He will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the place where his earthly father David sat. He will be king over the family of Jacob forever, and his nation will never have no end. The Holy Spirit will come on you. The power of the Most High will cover you. The Holy Child you give birth to will be called the Son of God. See, your cousin Elizabeth, as old as she is going to give birth to a child. She was not able to have children before, but now she is in her 6th month. For God can do all things.
Mary is willing to be used to bring God's plan into being, and she accepts everything that the angel has said will happen. Thank you. tremendous responsibility. Her faith in God is her lifeline. But this girl has the kind of trust that makes her Creator smile. So he decides to give her faith a boost. The Holy Spirit reminds her that the angel told her that her cousin Elizabeth was also expecting a miracle baby. Her decision to visit her cousin is a natural one. Her parents don't know what's happening, neither does her husband-to-be. She has no idea how they will react or if they will believe her. So imagine her relief when she gets this welcome from Elizabeth.
Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the child you will bear. But why am I so favored that the mother of the Lord should come to me? As soon as the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the baby in my womb leaped for joy.
Please stand if you're able and join us in hymn number 123, O Come, Emmanuel. Shows his heart. He needs to be away from her, because every time he sees her, his heart breaks anew. But he won't expose her to public disgrace and possible punishment because he still loves her. So when the angel delivers his message to Joseph, this time in a dream, the word is received gladly. For Joseph, this is the finest news that he could have hoped for, and more than anything he could have imagined. The girl his soul loves does in fact love him too. The rival he thought he had is none other than the God of Israel. Joseph will continue the traditional rites of marriage, sheltering Mary's good name in his own, and sharing the burden and the blessing of knowing that God himself has chosen them as his gateway to enter human life.
Small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me
the one who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from of old, before ancient times.
Thank you.
They're taking shelter where they can find it. In a place where animals escape the elements, they're huddled together near a manger. The only help and comfort Mary has is Joseph. Joseph and the Most High himself. But she has all she needs.
Assigned to you, you will find a baby wrapped in cloths
lying in a manger. Please stand for number 137. What child is this?
Thank you.
Peace. Amen. And Merry Christmas.